So I was kind of tired of saying, question. And so I just write a number of these that I was asking about it. So, this is something I'm talking about. Honestly,
her in the cars. I snuck all the wall. So for her, like,
night together.
It's what am I called? Sean Lawless. Or the law, brother. Oh, this is awful.
She'll be like, let's teach it all. She'll be okay. I don't ask for a teacher. All my subjects are students.
Part of my life is working with the same about their kids. It's all much harder than that.
Do you find it fire and search for the beauty?
Which is how it does. It's awful. It's just Artificial health, health, and farm. And that, where the head inside, breaks where it's in front of the barrel's color, the barrier,
So her answer, of course, is that before they farm that's choice, they have to get it.
And you do a walk of code and sort of go from a small thing that's okay, and just run it out of walk of code.
So what we'll do is just as a stretch. So we're going in and then when they go back to the curve, they can do it. So we can this and then I'll do it again. So what's it? The next thing that we start talking about is how to do that. So always talk about how and then actually, and myself, that students at younger ages are starting to code. This opens up to new and expressive say how they can take a profile and then like a shortage. But the students are like, yeah, right here. And that feels just as well. Not only to college education, but to be a part of the network. like that for the next test. And figure it out. But the best part about it is that it also tastes good. Both of us know this. Yeah, I hope
you're also first for knowledge.
I'm here to sell it to you. So, how does taste work? If you are the super tasters that experience food differently than the rest of us, mammals like you, me, and your dog taste food using taste buds, which are made by teeny tiny cells called taste receptors. When we eat, these cells bind on small molecules in our food related to flavor, and the flavors that these cells can detect are sweet, salty, bitter, sour, and umami. But did you know that not all food tastes the same to every human? About 25% of us have four times more taste buds, and thus more taste receptors than the average person. These, my friends, are called super tasters. And it's kind of like being a super. But instead of flying, we need to enjoy the scent. At Yale University in the 1950s, psychologist Dr. Linda Barbicha pioneered the study of genetic variation in taste. Through her study, Dr. Barbicha discovered that many people were incredibly sensitive to flavor, specifically. And she named those people who would be super tasters. She also found that 50% of patients are just plain tasters, and the other 50% are tasters. Don't be fooled by the term plain taster. It doesn't mean they can't taste at all. It just means they taste food less intensely, which might sound bad, but think of all the spices that plain tasters can eat to impress their food. But we shouldn't let these differences divide us. Tasters are so, you think you would be a super taster? Let's find out. Here's some food that you might eat there. Frosty, grapefruit, chocolate. Okay, chocolate. I'll do anything. Nice. No, it's not bitter. I guess I'm not a super taster. Maybe I have a smell. Did it work? It's not so thick, they can sell for their owner's life. On good word. What do you think? How do you work? And H2O. I don't know. But definitely H2O will get to that last episode. Just a second. Great.
Calcium chloride solution. I'm going to take my distilled water, add it to our bowl. Now I'm going to take my calcium chloride beads, take 3/4 teaspoon, add it to my bowl. Now I'm going to take my spoon and just mix it all together. And once you don't see any beads, I'm going to take sodium alginate solution that I made earlier, distilled water, sodium alginate powder, sodium alginate. So far, it's frozen. So what is polymer? Polymer is just a little chain of molecules all together. So the reason why it's a whole word just by squeezing sodium out of water, as it's just sodium out of water, added to a calcium chloride mixture, calcium chloride is sodium out of polymer. But that's as you change to gel, similar to gelatin, which is what gives these worms their cool texture. The polymers in these worms are technically edible, but I just had lunch, so I'm not going to eat them. Polymers are incredible. Polymers from food oil are used in things like our plastics and our synthetic rubber, also our clothing. So polyester is fine.
2 minutes. 3 minutes.
This is a side show.
Thank you.